Hello, my name is Shane Sploros and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to do a Q&A and I've asked my subscribers to leave me questions on a community post I did a few days ago. I was going to do 20 questions for the end of 2020, but I'm not sure if I got 20 questions, but we'll see how we go. I'm not in my music room today. I'm outside, got a coffee, thanks to someone who bought me a coffee via buymeacoffee.com. Thanks, Jerry. This is one of five coffees I'm having. I am in the center of town and I'm just climbing up the bridge, which is almost on the border in New South Wales and Victoria. And there's the train station in the background there, and apparently that's the longest platform in the southern hemisphere. And I'm not going to go down there today because it's quite busy. Alessandra asked me, how do I find new pieces to learn, especially when I haven't heard them before? Well, all the pieces that I do play, I've actually heard before, and that's influenced me to learn it. So I'm sorry to disappoint you. Most of the time, or 99% of the time, I hear them from other people and I go ahead and learn them. The next question is from Alison, and she asks if I find the piano useful to learning organ repertoire. Well, I don't practice directly on the piano for organ music because I do have an organ at home to practice on. But I think my years of piano playing and training have definitely helped me with technique, even though it's a slightly different technique. Now time for a question by John Higgins. He asks, how do I learn pieces so fast and upload new content so regularly? Well, I think I've formed and developed the habit. I practice regularly. Practicing is not a chore for me. I find it enjoyable to learn new pieces. And the more you do something, the easier it becomes. So I think there's no magic or silver bullet to it. It's just, I'm just basically doing what I love and I enjoy it. And because I do it so often, it becomes very natural for me. Now another question from John Higgins. How did I develop my finger technique to be so good? Well, I don't really know how to answer that question. There wasn't a book that I followed. I just did what I did. I just learned all my pieces, learned pieces that I wanted to learn. All those years of piano exams, public performances. Again, if you love something so much, it just becomes second nature. I didn't bog myself down in Hannon exercises, stuff like that. I just learned repertoire and did the scales required for exams, because you can cover all that technique in repertoire and scales. What do you think of finger exercises for the keyboard? Well, a lot of questions about finger technique and exercises. I suppose that they do have their value. Otherwise, there wouldn't be any publications or books or instructional material on it. But again, I never really spent time on this. I'd rather learn repertoire, and all those techniques are covered in repertoire. And in daily practice routine, I don't dedicate 50 minutes to scales, 15 minutes to this piece, 50 minutes to another piece. I just kind of wing it, I suppose. Whatever piece is screaming for the most work, I will work on first. Whatever piece that's pressing the most and needs to be learnt faster, if it's a recital or a recording. Alessandra sent me another question. How many hours do I spend listening to organ and choral music a week? I don't know. I will look at my YouTube stats and show you here in the video once I edit it. But yeah, I do listen to a lot of organ music. I listen to a lot of piano music as well. Not so much choral music. I have a lot of organ subscriptions and friends that I follow, so I listen to them. Interestingly enough, I ask a lot of my friends what they listen to, outside their interests in sacred music, organ music, piano music, and they tend to not listen to it outside the performing space. I've just never really got into other genres of music, but of course I do appreciate them. I wouldn't know where to begin to listen to music outside the stuff I already know. Perhaps you could suggest some music for me to listen to on Spotify. Vidas asked me a question saying, how do I manage to get 30k views every month? Well, the question is, why aren't I getting 100k views every month? Or why haven't I reached 100k subscribers? I really want that silver play button. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed to my channel already. If I just take a guess, it's probably because I'm just uploading regularly and providing a variety of content. And I hope this video is kind of cool because I'm answering these questions not in my music room. I'm going for a walk with a coffee in the middle of my town on the bridge. Lawrence Paul asks me, when did I start playing the organ? And is there a difference between 16-bit and 24-bit in loading sample sets? I first started learning the organ in 2011, which is just under a decade. So I guess you could say I'm living proof of someone who can learn an instrument, a second instrument, in their 20s. So it doesn't really matter what age you are. And if you miss that childhood learning stage, you can still learn a second instrument. I did it. I learned the organ from the very beginning. I don't know the technicalities of loading sample sets in 16 or 24 bit. But I know 24-bit is what you want to aim for. It sounds better. 16-bit is very artificial when you have a lot of stops going. But there is a trick. I only have 32 gig of RAM in my Hauptwerk machine, and some of the larger sample sets I can't load everything with full releases, full sample loops, and all that stuff. If you load everything in 24 bits, all sample loops, all releases, and you truncate the releases, say to 250 milliseconds, I find I can load everything in 24-bit. And because of the power of Hauptwerk 5 and 6, you can add some convolution reverb and it sounds amazing. You just have to experiment and be patient. Sonus Paradisi actually has a couple of files, which I'll play for you after this. Demonstrating the differences in 16 and 24-bit sample set loading. So let me know what you think. Vulcan Starlight, he asked me a question. Who's my favorite organ firm and builder? A tough one. I don't know. If I would have to pick one, I'd just go with the one I knew, which is Latorno, which is the main instrument I play here in Albury. Alessandra asked me another question. What is my favorite organ stop? Well, I do have a fascination with 32-foot stops, in particular 32-foot flutes or flues. And if you follow me on some other social media channels, my handle is Contrabourdon. And Contrabourdon is a 32-foot rank of pipes, often played with the pedals. And I just love that rumble of the 32-foot sound. I don't necessarily like 32-foot reeds, they're too in your face. I prefer really purring bass. I hope that the audio quality is okay with this because it's a really noisy highway. And that's the end of this Q&A. I'm not sure if we got to 20 questions or not, but I'll rename the video once I edit everything. Have a great 2020 and I'll see you in 2021. Bye for now.